give me that Becky.
Give me that Becky.
Alright, PMS,
PMS Radio, here with Lazy K.
PMS Radio.
You fit right in. You fit right in.
Alright.
So let us know. Wait, you gonna join the team?
Well, you know, I'm here. Whatever y'all girls need.
That's what's up.
I'm feeling the name. Yeah.
It stands for play my shit.
What you say?
Play my shit.
Play my shit.
That's what you do. PMS. Like, you play the good shit?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Play my shit. No PMS doubt. Radio. No play doubt. My shit.
Okay.
Okay, for those of them dumb people who don't know who you are.
Those slow people.
Oh, man.
Let them know.
Okay, this is DJ Lazy K. Yes, it's the lady. Hello? Nah, let me stop now. I'm the mixtape queen. You know, I hold the mixtape game down for I don't know how long already. And
think about it. How many years?
Oh, man. Years. Because I remember being like this tall doing my first mixtape.
Who was on your first mixtape?
A whole bunch of Spanish music. Nothing to do with what I do now. But
how did you make the transition into hip-hop?
I don't know. I guess with it was that song Lottie Lottie got
we
me into it and the show. And I used to watch my cartoons, and then I heard the beatbox and the dancing with it. I was like, oh, I'm switching over.
I just ran with it.
So I understand you didn't always live in the States. You were born in Mexico and
yeah.
then lived in Spain, right?
Oh, you read my bio. So we got to PMS Radio.
We know about so, you. Coming to the States, how did you
I
get
was
into
born in Mexico. Just born in Mexico, and then I went right from there to Spain. I was raised in Madrid. I did my school in Madrid, and about 12 years. You went to Madrid?
I visited.
Oh, you visited. Oh, that's good. It's really fun over there. I'm dying to go back and be like, yeah, I'm Lazy K now. From New York. But Madrid is definitely a very party atmosphere, and I learned a lot of music over there. And at the age of 16, I said bye-bye to Europe, and I came right straight to the United States by myself.
Wow. So what made you leave? What made you want to come to this?
Family. I had it with my family. Mm-hmm. I just had to go as far as I can go.
In another country.
In another country. Another land. Another water. It was a family
right
of women.
And
just, you just move around the corner.
Yeah, we just go to each other's house. So, I mean, how hard was it, the transition? I mean, you're a female.
16 years old.
Well, you know, at 16, you don't care. 16, you just want to live your life. Mm-hmm. Especially where I came from, it was very strict.
Okay.
I came from a very type of different family, you know, like very, you're going to be a doctor, we got you on college, you're going to be a good girl, and this, this, and that. And when I found hip-hop, it's all of a sudden my mind changed.
You
like, you know what? I like the baggy jeans, I need some fitted, I need to know where they got them shoes from. And I took my mind, I actually worked, I saved my money, I was going to school, and at 16 in Europe, you kind of got a lot more freedom than over here. For some reason, I ended up in the plane, they didn't ask me for
Wow.
I mean, they didn't ask me for a signature from my parents and nothing. I was just crossing my fingers like, did you
tell them you were leaving?
No.
You was on a plane.
Who are you?
I came to visit, girl. You know, I'm a visitor. I'm still visiting.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
We
don't
want you deported.
We don't
want you deported.
Nah, I'm good. I got me covered now.
So do you speak to your family?
Yeah, I spoke to my family actually like 5 years later.
Were they supportive?
Yeah.
So wait, what did they think happened to you?
She just walked out the house.
I thought you was like, wait, you was probably all over Europe. Missing, like.
Well, honestly, that's where I got the name Lazy K, because I had a koala bear book bag, and that's all I had with me.
Wow.
So that was the Lazy K, you know, the Lazy Koala, K from Karina. So actually, it was really tough for my family, because I ran from home. Mm-hmm. And